Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff. This video is specifically for Mac users who have a converted Epson printer. If you have been using your converted printer with your Mac, you may have noticed that some of the recent updates have removed the color matching option when trying to install an ICC profile on your Mac computer. In this video, I'm going to give you some options on how to work around this missing color matching option. This is not my first video on ICC profiles. I actually have a very popular video that covers basically everything you need to know about color correction using a converted Epson printer. So if you have a PC, if you have an older Mac, or you just want to know more about the color correction process, go ahead and watch that video first. I will link that down in the description so you can easily find it. But like I said, this video is specifically for Mac users with that newer operating system. I believe this happened during the Ventura update. It definitely happened when I did my Sonoma update, and it will probably continue to be an issue as they release new operating systems. So in this video, we're going to find some workarounds so that you can still use that color correction on your sublimation projects. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to hop onto my computer and we're going to update the drivers for this printer. With the update, a lot of people have said that basically Mac is overwriting the drivers for their particular printer. So we're going to go and we're going to find the drivers for my specific printer. I'll show you where to find them for yours. And we're going to install the new drivers onto our Mac computers so that we can see if that can help take care of the color syncing option. So here I am at Epson Printer Support. I will leave a direct link to this page in the description below so you can find it. Let's go ahead and go down here and search by our product name. You can search by printer types and everything, but it gets kind of convoluted. So I'm just going to type in the name of my EcoTank. So I have an ET2850. I'm going to click on 2850 here, and it brings me right to the machine I have. Now, in the past, sometimes it will select an operating system for you. Here, it is no longer doing that for me, but when it did, it never selected the one I actually had. So you want to make sure that you're selecting your actual operating system. Now, if I go up here to the top left of my MacBook here, and I click on the little apple, I can go to About This Mac, and I can see what I'm running. So I'm running Mac OS Sonoma 14.3. And then I can go down to this dropdown and select the right one. Now it has 14.x, meaning that any version of Sonoma here, 14, will work. So I'm gonna choose 14.x, and then I'm going to hit go. Now if I scroll down, you'll see here that it has pulled up the correct file for me. So I'm going to go ahead and download it. Once it's downloaded, I'm going to open it, and I'm going to double click on it. My Mac will ask if I want to open it. I'm going to click open, and then it requests access to my downloads folder. That's fine with me. Allow. Again, I'm going to click open, and then it's going to install my file. You'll get a few warnings here. The first is that it's going to set up the product for use on this particular computer. So I'm going to click OK. Then we have our license agreement, and you can read this before you go to bed. It'll help you fall asleep. I'm going to click accept. Here it's going to talk about data collection. You can decide whether or not you want it to collect data. I'm going to click next. Then the installer will confirm that you have your printer turned on and that you have filled the ink tanks, or you have ink in the tanks. You'll have to click a little box that said, I finished filling the tanks, then click next. If you have already used this printer on your network before, it may find it for you, so it's finding me. If not, you'll have to go through setting it up, so I'm going to click next. In the next screen, you'll be asked to select what software you want to install. It has the required software already checked at the top. You can choose whether or not you want to install these other things. I'm going to keep them all checked and click install. Next, your computer will open up the printers and scanners window. You may need to add yours here by going to add printer. Because I already had it installed, mine actually appears here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and close this. Now it's gonna have me print a test page. And then after you print your test page, you can update your firmware. Just make sure not to turn off your computer or your printer. So I'm gonna go ahead and click next and allow it to do that. All right, my software is installed. I'm going to click finish and register. I'm not gonna register my product because I've put sublimation ink in it and the warranty is not valid anyway. So I'm just gonna close that. So from the research I have done, this has worked to actually have that color matching appear for a handful of people. I really hope it's you, it's not me. But I do have the most updated printer drivers as well as the most expansive printer drivers uploaded now. If you just run with the printer drivers that the Mac automatically uploads, you have way fewer options. So no matter what you do, you will want to go in and keep those drivers updated just so that you are getting the most current version of the drivers from Epson. So let's look at this sample document I've made here. Now, if I go to print, You'll see that I get the printer settings here. I can get more settings down here as well. And in older operating systems, if I click print using system dialog, I'm able to find color matching here and select an ICC profile. But there's no way for me to select that ICC profile in any of the options in here, unfortunately. And this means that we're not going to be able to use those ICC profiles with a lot of programs that you used to be able to use it with. You can't use it with Google Docs, Cricut Design Space, Silhouette Studio, I think Affinity Designer. There are a bunch that are just sort of now off the table if you're using that ICC profile. So now I'm gonna share a couple workarounds I found. Are they as good as printing from the programs we're super comfortable with? No, but they are an option if you don't want to necessarily upgrade your Epson EcoTank to something like a Brother or Sawgrass sublimation printer that has the color management built into it. I have one free option for you as well as a paid version, so let's go ahead and look at that free one first. The first option is to use something that actually comes for free with your Mac, and that is the preview window. So I'm actually going to create a copy, because if you open it in preview and you make changes, you're actually making changes to the original, and you don't really want to save over that original if you're making edits. I'm going to control click here, and I'm going to go duplicate. And so we have a copy. Now I'm just gonna leave it called copy, and then I'm going to double click it, and this opens it in preview. Now you can actually make some edits here in preview. First, we're going to go to tools, and we're going to flip horizontal. This reverses our image so that it appears correctly when we go to sublimate it on our blank. Then I'm going to go to tools, adjust size, because I don't really need this to be 13 inches wide. I want it more like 9. So I'm gonna click 9 and click okay. And you can see here my image is much smaller. Then I'm going to go to tools, assign profile. And then from here, you can actually assign that ColorSync profile. It's amazing to me that this exists in something as simple as preview, but doesn't exist in our other printing options. So I'm gonna choose my Hippo ink here, and I'm going to click okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and print my file. And you can see here in the preview that the color over here on the left doesn't look quite right, and that is because it has that profile attached to it. You can double check all of your other settings and print. You can see now when I go back to my Finder window, I have the original that I made here, Birthday Squad, and then I have the version that I edited here, and it is backwards with that profile. So you just wanna make sure that you always have that original, because you may wanna do something else with it, and it's really hard to sort of go back to where you started. As you edit things, they start to lose resolution, and you wanna make sure you have that original file on hand so that you're not editing that original. The next option is good old Photoshop. I have already resized this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and go directly into that print window. And from here, you can change your color handling and your printer profile. So a lot of times printer manages colors will be selected. You'll wanna change that to Photoshop manages colors. And from there, under printer profile, you can choose which of your printer profiles you want to use. I love that Photoshop has this built-in color management, because it means that you can do it really easily. But on the flip side, this is about $20 a month. So you may think that this is worth it. It's something that you use a lot. You do a lot of sublimation. But if it's not for you, then you may want to try the preview option. Do note in Photoshop that when you go to print, you do want to scroll all the way down and click emulsion down, and that will flip your image properly so that you can print it. So I wish I had better news that I was able to find that color matching or color sync dropdown in just the regular print dialog box. Unfortunately, I didn't. I do think this is something that you could potentially reach out to Apple about and say, hey, I was using color matching, I need it back, and maybe they'll add it back in a future update. I really hope that one of the two sort of alternate options I found for you will work. Remember that that preview is actually free, so definitely start there. Photoshop is really good for sublimation. You can also do the same selecting of profiles in Adobe Illustrator if you have that as well. It's the same exact process. Basically, if you are thinking about getting into sublimation more, you may want to think about investing in something like Photoshop, just because it's so robust. You can make your own designs, you can really edit things very easily. But again, $20 a month, I know not everybody has it, so it's really up to you and what your budget allows you to do. I hope you found this video about using an ICC profile on your Mac helpful. I know it's not 100% the answer you were looking for, but there are some options. If you have any questions, or if maybe miraculously you have figured it out, please leave that down in the comments. And if you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate a like. Follow my channel for more weekly Cricut, sublimation, and laser content. I'll see you next week.